Hi guys, Conan Salmon here from LBC. Today I'm going to show you around our fully enclosed, fully automated bin cleaning truck. This is the truck. It's a MANTGL and it originally started its life back in France over 10 years ago, where it cost over £110,000 for the original build. We purchased it back in 2018. We went over to Belfast to buy it off a company that was using it for a lot of hospital bin cleaning, and the USPs of this truck really make it attractive to councils. This has been a real asset to our fleet. We've cleaned tens of thousands of commercial bins for several London councils over the last 3 years with it. It's done 150,000 miles and the whole system works by power takeoff. So it's got a PTO button. So all the equipment in the back is run off the main engine. So as you can see, it's a very high-tech bit of kit. This is the main wash arm, which comes forward. The whole cradle comes forward when the bin is in the cleaning position. It also goes left to right, and it's got several sensors on it. So here in the back of the truck, this is where all the wastewater collects and all the dirt from the bins collects. And then you've got these two filters. And once the wastewater gets up to a certain level, the water filters through these filters and down into this chamber, where we've got a filter system that recirculates the dirty water, filters it and pumps it back up to the main tank. So in here is the main control panel. I'll just talk you through the different switches on here. You've got the external for the external wash in the chamber. That's if you want to wash the outside of the bin as well during the wash cycle. You've got your recycler here, which is the filter and pump system that recycles the water and pumps it back up to the main tank. You've got the electrical reset, which is a safety thing. Every time you turn on the power, you hit the electrical reset to start. You've also got the external lights. You've got the test mode. So if you turn this and then press wash cycle, the back system will go through a wash cycle without squirting out any water, so you can see how the robot's working and how it's moving from side to side. The recycle wash, when you press this button, it will force some water through the recirculator to clean it. In here is the main pump. Now this is the primary pump. It's a Pratisoli HF25. These sell for between 4 and 5K when they're new, and it's a 280 bar at a massive 74 liters per minute. So this is the pump that powers that main robotic arm in the back to clean out the bins when they're in the wash position. This is the main unloader. Over here you've got a valve where you can fill up from a hydrant, and you can also empty the tank fairly quickly. In this housing here, you've got your main filter before the main pump to protect the pump from any dirt from the main tank once you've recycled a few bins. So I'm now in this area which is right behind the main cab, and in here we've got the water tank, we've got the secondary pump, and we've also got all the hydraulics. So I'll go through them one by one and explain what they do. This is the secondary pump. It's about a 15 litre per minute pump at 200 bar, so it's ideal for washing the outside of bins, for washing out bin stores, or for little driveway cleaning or even car park cleaning. So there's also a switch at the back of the lorry which says HP Lance, and that puts the power away from the primary pump onto this secondary motor and powers this secondary pump. And this pump controls the Lance at the back of the truck. This is the main water tank in the truck. It's 1500 litres. It's got an overflow so that you can't overflow the top as it goes into the back compartment. It's also got a hose up there which comes from the recirculator, which pumps the dirty water once filtered back to the tank. After this tank, we've got a couple more filters, a small filter here for the small secondary pump, and the big filter the other side, which I've already showed you. So we've had this handy shelf built which sits on top of the secondary pump, which is ideal for storing chemicals, etc. This is one of the main valves for emptying the back of the wash compartment, and in here is the recirculator. So in here we've got a centrifugal recirculator, which is one of the best filtration and pumping systems I've ever seen before. It's a combination of hydraulics and high pressure. So with the high pressure, you can press the button over on the main control panel, and it blasts four jets of water in to clean it out. And then it's also got a hydraulic motor, which spins the system, spins the filter. It's got about three filters within it. And when the hydraulic motor is spinning the filter, it spreads all the dirt out and into this compartment. So this compartment, after a full day's washing, will be full of sludge that needs to be cleaned out. And when it spreads it out, it also pumps it back the vortex system spins it out to the side and pumps it back to the main tank at the same time. So it's very high tech, but a great bit of kit. So under here we've got another compartment hatch, which is very useful for cleaning out the back of the truck. You can drop this, it's all stainless steel, you can drop this down and then clear out the truck very easily. This here is also for draining off any additional liquid before you open up the hatch. This is the Lance, which is powered by the secondary pump, and it is on a 15 meter retractable hose reel. So this is the main bin lift at the back of the truck. It's powered by the hydraulics, and unlike other bin lifts, it's got a swinging arm here and proximity sensors, which make it adaptable to attach to many different types of commercial bin. You can either have two domestic size 240s or 360s, or you can also have a range of different 1100 litre Euro carts, etc. There's some grease points on the lift, and it's been well serviced and greased regularly. And the proximity sensors, it's got two proximity sensors over here, and they basically make sure, for safety reasons, that the bin is in the right position before it lifts up. Once the bin lifts up, it's clamped into position and the door closes. So before I put a bin in, I just wanted to show the power of the robotic arm. So I'm going to leave the door open. You're not meant to, but just to show you the power, the cleaning power in the back. Hit the emergency stop there to stop it, but hopefully you were able to see the power that comes out the back. 280 bar at 74 litres powered by that big HF25 pump. Yeah, so guys, I'm going to show you what a bin looks like before we put it in for a wash, and then afterwards you can see how it comes out. Are you good? So I hope you've enjoyed this video explaining how the LBC Terminator truck works. It's helped us over the last few years to secure contracts for several of the London councils and housing associations, and it has some great USPs, being that it's fully enclosed and fully automated. Thanks for watching, and if you've got any questions, please leave them in the comments below. If you've liked this video, please make sure to subscribe to our channel and check out our other videos. You can click here to see our other new commercial bin cleaning truck in action, and you can click here for some more pressure washing videos.